Başa! Second teaching. Sorry about that. Shonji Nikyo. Hello? Perfect! Last time. Be careful. One of the things that happens with this one a lot is we try to enter, but instead we just push her away. Or if our partner is stronger, we just run into a roadblock. So, if I first of all pull my hips under me, look how she changed already. Instead of having my shoulders leaning, I pull my hips under my shoulders. And then, if I let this ride up, because that's where this is coming from, she attacked this way. So, if this is going up, so I can allow it to continue going up. And then, if I bend my knees too, and think about leading with the kneecaps rather than the as long as it is, then you run much less chance of tripping the arms.
Thank you.
Uno. And then this is the third. It's all very important. Very helpful. So if you think about just going in, like as if you were just shaving, right? Not running away from this in that way, but instead into the eye of the storm, and then this is. And, you know, we don't have real swords in here. And even without real swords, we're nice people. We're nice to each other. So it's very rare that, for example, I'll attack. And if you don't pull that shoulder, go ahead and do it though. Yeah, sorry, I kind of made that happen. But it's very common that he gets here, but this gets left behind. All right? So, that's the martial side of it. But aside from the martial side, when I come in with this attack and that suddenly snaps back and away, sometimes maybe you've attacked somebody where oftentimes you attack and like, wow, great, they dodged it. But every now and then you attack and you go, whoa. And what makes the difference? That's one of the things that can possibly make the difference. Anyway, that's nice. This snapping back to really give him the feeling that he just hit a bad thing. Hey, that's all. And it certainly gets you out of the way. Everybody, I can see everybody loves Aikido. So it's tempting to. And then it's like, yeah. But take the time when you get here, check and see if you really are wanting it. I know I'm still missing the mark by about 5 or 10 years. Okay? 35+ years, so.
You're probably missing the mark over sometimes.
Okay? So take your time, settle in. And what I find is that I can't get that extra 5 or 10 degrees unless I bend my knees, both of them. And pull my shoulders back. Okay? So build some muscle memory with that. Will you see what happens? What it looks like? Hey, that was all. Take your time. Filled with what? Filled with muscle memory. The body that you have now, you can. Then you get a step up. And. Step, reach your head, weight shift, and a weight shift. She's in front of me. You're in front of me. That's why I got all the way back there. If they're next to me, then I end up yanking you. So get all the way back here, and now they're in front of me. Keep them in front of you. You turn. Keep them in front of you. Okay? So the tendency will be to let this go behind you, right? And then to throw me. Okay? And then some styles, they will throw and you do a throw. Yeah. That. However, all that. Right? But instead, just rip past it as close as you can. Okay. So now, here, we'll let this rest here. Then, one step back. Just enter. Now this stays. This stays through the pin, everything, to the very end, until you let him stand back up. This doesn't change. Once it gets to here and here, it doesn't change. Still there. Still there. That's one thing about Otogeko. I was talking last time about the training after training. The training after class. After class already you're very tired. And now you're being encouraged to get thrown more. So you get tired more. Finally your brain shuts off, thank goodness. And you can think about how to do a new technique, how to do something different. Before you know it, your body's done it. Nabi also, take care of your uke. So you'll take care under a proper. Hi, Lizzo. Sorry. What's the name of it?
Munetsuki Kotegaike.
Munetsuki Kotegaike. Yes, there she is returning. So Munetsuki Kotegaike. 说问题，来。
Nobody else is on the top.